Welcome to another episode of What to Do at Home Even Before You Put Your Shoes on Trainers to Go Running. Last week, on the first episode, I said that today we're going to be using a weight, like a plate, and a towel. I changed my mind. For the next few episodes, I'm going to be concentrating on the mobilities, whole body, but like we started on the foot last week, so we're going to keep moving up, then into the activation, then we're going to be doing the exercises outside, just before you go running, then we're going to go into strength and so on. So today we're going to follow onto the mobility higher up towards the hip, like this. And I have to remind you, before you do this, you have to do what we already done on episode number one. So following up from here, you're going to take a step and reach up high with the elbow straight, pushing your hip and your knee in front. In out, rounding your back. You don't want to feel this on your back at all. You want to feel it there. Hip flexors. From here, you're going to sit. Remember, foot flat, not on your toes for this one. You're going to sit in out using your hands. Reach up. That's one. Two, and so on. Sit on the other side, flat, step, sit all the way down, even out using your hands, and back. One, two, and so on. You got the idea. Then, and as you come up, you're gonna turn your back leg, so you have a right angle here at the knee. Step in the same place as the other stretch, or I should say the other mobility. Carry on pushing it forwards, but don't let your shoulders turn away from this knee. So keep it in line with the knee here. So you're gonna push in front, you're going to step this leg all the way behind you. Sometimes I trap my knee to push this leg in front because this leg sometimes wanna follow my other leg. So I make sure it stays there and I can even hold on to it and stretch this leg behind you all the way. Then your back leg is gonna come in. So you have a right angle at the front, you have a right angle at the back leg, you have a right angle at the hip, 90-90. Then you're going to stand up without using your hands. Forwards this way, step again and push. You are going to turn to the side with your feet sideways and carefully, if you've never done this before, carefully sit back on your heels with your foot sideways. Some people are going to feel the groin, some people are going to feel the knees, some people are going to feel the ankles, some people are not going to feel anything. If you've never done it before, assist with your hands and sit slowly. Come up, do your pelvic tilt. You should know what pelvic tilt is. And really push this forwards, without leaning back, without using your lower back. So it is pelvic tilt, really pushing this forwards. Step to the other side. Remember this foot pointing away, right under the knee. Push the knee with your shoulders following the knee. step behind. Now you can see here my knee chopping my foot, my leg again, so it stays in front. Then you can grab the hand all the way behind. Go to 90-90, remember 90 here, 90 at the front. Stand up without using your hands. You step in front, face forward, and sit. And you just repeat the sequence. You can go back and forth in the video, instead of me doing all over again and the video taking 3 hours. Think about the angles. 90-90, the foot sideways, pushing your hips, pushing your knees with the shoulders in front when the legs are twisted. Think about your arm really straight here when you're pushing your hip forward. Move the back leg straight. Remember, everything has to be in line. There's no point in doing the arms bent. Some people do the arms bent, one, because they're not thinking about it, and the worst is when they cannot actually do it because everything is so tight. So, you're not holding the position, you are moving from one position to another. Make a flow, do 5 times. Be patient, make it work. It has to flow from one to another without really using your hands to assist the movement. Maybe to begin with, you're gonna have to. Sometimes people don't have the strength, the mobility, the flexibility to do it. And more you practice and less hands you use, just from doing this as a warm up, you are going to become stronger and more mobile, sometimes even more flexible. But remember, you don't wanna do too much because this is not a workout. You're preparing yourself to go running. I am gonna keep this video simple as this for today because I really want you to work this position because we are not done yet within this flow movement. So the next video, I'm gonna add on top of this, flow from one to another. Rodrigo Perez, Athlete X. Today was episode 2, and I will see you Thursday again, episode 3, that we're gonna build on top of this sequence. I'll see you then.